Uka chaka, uka, uka, uka chaka, uka, uka, uka chaka, uka, uka, uka chaka, uka, uka.
I can't stop this feeling deep inside of me. Girl, you just don't realize what you do to me. When you hold me in your arms so tight, you let me know everything's alright.
Start a Met Regatta. With exams out of the way, our attention turns to the start of our Henley campaign. With seats still up for grabs and combinations yet to be tested, the weekend provided a platform to motivate our crew and kickstart the Temple campaign. We left Dorney, returning to Exeter to complete the final round of seat racing. These next 2 weeks will be our final sessions in Exeter before moving into host houses for Marlow and Henley. With sea racing complete, we had our crew.
Yeah, so enough. We're rolling.
So I'm just saying my name.
Just your name. Yeah, just say your name and what seat number you're in.
Matt Shaw, bow seat. Billy Jane, 2 seat.
Josh Farnham, 3 seat.
Do you just
yeah, go? Yeah, okay. Just go. Yeah, just go.
Tristan Gavalic, 4 seat.
Tristan Taylor, 5 seat.
Rhys Powell, 6 seat.
Josh Terrell, 17.
Joe Elwig, stroke seat.
Tom Goodwin, Cox.
We had our crew, but something was missing. Something yellow. The kangaroo had served us well, but it was time for an upgrade. A week after Met, we took a trip with the Cox 4 down to Abingdon to trial 2 of their shells. On behalf of the crew, I'd like to say a huge thank you to the sponsors of this campaign and anyone who donated to our Just Giving page. The next stop was Marlow Regatta. We were confident that if we performed on the day, we'd be within a chance of pre-qualifying for the Wednesday of Henley. So it all came down to the time trial. We had to perform. We started strong, coming hard out of the blocks and moving on to a solid rhythm. We had a nice sprint coming through the last 500 metres and came off the water feeling pretty confident. The times came through and we were the fifth fastest crew, placing us into the A final. We knew that if we could stay within the mix, through the middle of the race, we could look at stealing a couple of places. We had a good start to the race, up with everyone through the first 500 metres. At the 1K mark, the field began to open up and we began to lag behind first, second and third. We finished the race in fifth place, so we're glad to have held our position coming into the final. We then left Dorney, drove back to the house to wake up to some news the following morning.
What?
We got a boy!
No way!
Yeah,
the boys!
So we had qualified for Henley. With this confirmed, we moved over to Henley for a week of training leading into qualifiers and the regatta.
Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right.
Now that we were in the regatta, our perspective could adjust. We could really start to enjoy the sessions and soak up the atmosphere across the week. In no time at all, the week was up and it was Friday, the day of qualifiers. Our men's squad were entering in two other boats for the regatta, the PA4 and the Prince of Wales squad.
Exeter! Yeah, let's go! Let's go, boys!
The following crews, in alphabetical order, have qualified for the Prince Albert Challenge Cup. Half universities. Exeter.
Yeah! Come on!
So we qualified two boats into the regatta. The draw was announced and had revealed that we'd be racing Boston University on the Wednesday. Now it was time to race.
So the next race is a heat of the Temple Challenge Cup between Boston University of the USA and Exeter University on the right of our picture in the green and white. Tidy steering from the crew from Exeter that we see in front of us here, staying close to the island. The cox of that boat, Tom Goodwin.
To ease your mind, please your heart. But all you ever want to do to me is make me.
For that group from Boston University on the far side, making a big move early in the race there.
You say that you really loved me, oh, you only need to be your man.
The crew from Boston College in good control at the front of this one. The crew from Exeter University, they were had a decent season racing around the British circuit, but they've gone up against a very strong crew here at Henley, as we see them cross the line to end their Henley 2019.